German-Jewish composer, pianist, and teacher. Moszkowski showed a musical talent for multiple things from an early age and studied piano, composition, and orchestration at the Julius Stern's Conservatory throughout his early years. In 1873, he made his first successful appearance as a pianist. Soon after, he began touring the country and rapidly gained popularity. Already by his early 20s, he was collaborating with artists such as Franz Liszt. Moszkowski composed, performed, and taught for the next decade, leading a successful career, but in the mid-1880s, he had to stop performing because of a neurological problem in his arm. He turned to conducting, composing, and teaching with even more passion and was highly sought after for the next 20 years. However, starting from the early 1900s, when he was in his 50s, his career began to decline because of his poor health. Unfortunately, his last years were spent in extreme poverty, and sadly, he died before the funds for his late pieces reached him. Instead, the money was used for his funeral.
This suite for two violins and piano in G minor is one of his last works. The first movement starts off with beautiful double stop chords and strings, which gives it a very energetic feeling. Gradually, the main theme appears, which is very romantic, with dialogues between the first violin and the second violin. The finale of this piece begins very buoyantly with a very playful feeling. Eventually, the main theme reappears again with a very romantic subject.
Unlike in a traditional piano trio, where the violinist, cellist, and the pianist, the pianist in this piece must take on the role of a cellist by playing the very important bass line. Of Moszkowski, the famous composer and pianist, Paderewski, said, quote, "After Chopin, he best understands how to write for the piano," end quote. When I first received this piece, I just looked at it and thought, wow, there are a lot of notes. But after coachings and rehearsals, I realized that while I do have to play all the notes that Moszkowski wrote for this piece, there are some notes, especially those in the bass line, which are more important than others. This, thinking of the piece in this way made it not only easier to play, but also much more enjoyable and musical. I hope you find the first and fourth movements of Moszkowski's suite for two violins and piano as compelling as we.